Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today we're going to talk about no daily maintenance for DTF printers. The caveat of this video is you don't have to do the daily maintenance and your printhead will never clog. Sounds too good? But this is for people who don't usually get orders. I get probably one order a week. Sometimes I don't have orders for 2 or 3 weeks. When orders come, usually it's a big order and they come together. This is not my DTF printer. This is an L1800 printer and I add a dye ink in the tanks. I use this printer to print my packing slip, so I use it daily. They will never clog. You can add a sublimation ink into this printer, so it will become your daily sublimation printer. When you have a DTF order, just move this printhead to your DTF machine. It sounds crazy because you have two machines, but I think this way, you have a DTF printer and also you have a sublimation printer or regular printer, and you share the same printhead. Another thing is you already spent, let's say $3,000 on a L1800 DTF printer, and you spend another $1,000 to have a spare parts. So anything broke in that printer, you have spare here. The printer comes with a brand new printhead and a brand new mainboard, and those two are really expensive. If you factor that in, it's pretty reasonable. You can go to bchtechnologies.com and go to DTF Direct to Film and click DTF Printer. And today we're talking about this brand new L1800 printer. You can just buy the straight with no ink. Or you can add dye ink if you want to use for regular documents or picture, or you can click add sublimation ink, which you use this printer as a sublimation printer. You can see it's a virgin printer. The most valuable thing is the printhead. There are lots of $1,000 DTL printers manufactured from old printheads. A real new printhead will run you about $450, and a real new mainboard will run you another $450. So you're looking for almost get the rest of the printer parts free. So before I move this printhead to the DTF, I print a nozzle check page. You can see it's perfect. I have another video show you how to take the printhead out. Basically, you dig out all the dampers first. I temporarily just put those dampers into a plastic bag, just in case they're going to drip ink. Then on the side, there are two tabs, one here and one below. Be careful. One time I used the dental tool and I slipped. The dental tool punched a hole on the FFC cable, that white ribbon, and I have to replace the whole thing. Since then, I'll try to be very careful or just use my nails. And then you're going to remove this plate and just use your dental tool to dig to the back of it and just lift it up and it's going to come out. It'll take some practice. Basically, you are trying to reach those two hooks. Let me show you where they are. Say this one right here and this one right here. If you break it, you can go to bchtechnologies.com and I think you can search for holder. And it's right here. Then use your screwdriver, remove the three screws, and then you can remove the printhead. And I don't have a printhead guard because I'm using this as a regular printer. Also, I need to remove the printhead lot. I have modified the ink system for this DTL printer. For the ink tank, I use a 75 mil tank with extender. Go to accessories, and ink tank. And I use a white one because lots of you buy the black one. I don't know why. So I have a lot of white one left. So I just grab one of this. The reason I'm using a smaller tank is because for my order, I only print maybe 30 mil for one order. So I don't want to have so much ink exposed to the air when I'm not using it. So I would rather have a smaller tank. So this is only for the KCMY. And also I cut the ink supply line short and I connect with an extender, search for extender. There are connector per extender. So if you can connect a tube on this one and connect another tube from other end. So it basically is easy on and off. you need to raise the extender above the ink line, otherwise it's not dripping down. And that's why I have a piece of duct tape there. The ink supply tubes are sucking from a bottle of distilled water right now. That's because I need to clean the waste tank line. And I see the cap station, how clean it is. And look, the ink supply line is all filled with distilled water. And this is my white ink tank. It basically is a bottle from here. Go to accessories and the waste tank. And this bottle, 500 ml bottle. It says waste tank, but however, I'm just using it as a white ink bottle. Every time I finish printing, I just put a cap on and seal it so this thing is not exposed to the air. Much easier to handle. Basically the same thing as you seal the ink inside the bottle. And you can just shake it, and since we have a machine here, we just put it on shaking and be ready in 10 minutes. When the white ink is ready, I'm going to just change the bottle. But however, let's connect all the color ink first. Basically, when you convert to this kind of ink system, you just cut off the KCM white color tubes and connect to the small white tank, 75 mil tank with extender. So you can control whether the printer is sucking ink from the white tank, or you put the tubes into a distilled water bottle and it will suck distilled water into the printer. You have six tubes, so we just connect the KCMY, and now we're going to figure the two white ink tubes. You have to figure out the flow direction of the tubes. The ink goes to the printer from one tube, and then it's looped back and dump the ink into the tank. So for the tube taking the ink to the printer, we call it a tube printer because it sucks ink from the tank. You want the tube be a little longer, but do not touch the bottom. You want ideally at least half inch or 1 inch from the bottom of the tank. And you don't want the ink to suck like debris or anything from the bottom. I'm going to do like this, has a half inch distance from the bottom. And for the tube that dumps the ink back to the bottle, it doesn't matter. I just let it go a little bit inside the bottle. As long as it can dump the ink into the bottle, I don't care. Here, you may already have motor. And I'm going to sell a motor with that cap at the DTF direct to film and DTF parts. Right now, I only have the motor. In this video, you can see I have another one that the motor can screw on to the cap and connect it to the bottle. Yeah, I'm still finalizing the design. So once I get that one ready, I'm gonna sell that one here too. So just check out this page or just subscribe to my channel. You're gonna get an update. And I get that tube ready, and now we can put the screw back. Oh, by the way, you don't have to do this every time. I'm just showing you how it's done. So next time you can just remove the whole thing and put it in the white ink tank. So what you actually do every time is just like this, unscrew the top and put this whole thing in. And the gray cap with ink is going to be available on my website. Now we put our printhead on. Put those FFC cables inside the curve. And put the three screws back and rotate among them to evenly screw it on the chase and make sure it is tight and even. And put the cable clip back and then put the damper holder back. Now for the color inks KCMY, I'm going to use a syringe to draw the ink in and also remove the old distilled water. You can use any syringe, but the tip that I use to draw the ink is search for tip. And it's this four piece plastic refill needle for quick ink transfer. And also it's really helpful for you if you write the number on the damper. So you just start from damper number one. It's easier for you to remember all the colors. And for this printer model, you don't need to manage the white dampers. However, I use the syringe to draw the distilled water out. And now we turn the manpower on without turning the printer on. And for this model, the mixer is going to work first. You can see it's mixing. And after it's mixing, you're going to hear the ink pump works. Hear that? And now you can check the white ink. You can make sure that the white ink is coming out from where it's supposed to come out of the tube. If you connect the tube correctly, you're going to see the white ink get dumped into this secondary tank. You can see the tubes on the right is white already, so it's dumping the ink into this tank. And here's another pump, and you can see the white ink come into the tank, so we did it correctly. And I have to go to dinner, and so I use this automatic script to do a one power cleaning first, then strong cleaning every hour. And when I come back, the printer should be ready. And I'm going to put a link above so you can watch how I set up the script. I'm also going to put a link in the description of this video. And I can guarantee a printhead should be as good as new. And look at those pretty white lines. Perfect. So basically every time I set it up, it's going to make me about $1,000. And so if I have a bad printhead, clock printhead, it's going to cost me $450. So basically if I have a guaranteed working printhead, I can make money back from this new printer right away. Okay, clean up. Let's start with those color KCMY first. We get a bottle of distilled water. Distilled water at the grocery store is about $1 a gallon. You know the extender. And if you need the tubes, just go to BCH and search for tubes. Now we remove the tubes from the tank and connect the tubes to our distilled water. Now when the printer sucks, it sucks out of this distilled water bottle. And for the white ink tube that goes into the printer, it's going to connect with distilled water. And the dump tube, going to dump to another bottle. Here, I let the dump into that clear bottle. And then I just fire up the macro on my computer and let it keep cleaning. I let it run overnight. When it comes in, you can see that this clear bottle is totally full of the white ink. And I mounted the printer back to my regular printer and do some head cleanings. And you can see I get my printer back and just keep using it. I'll never clog. You might wonder why I keep cleaning overnight. The reason is the white ink can clog inside the tube, can clog inside the printhead, can clog inside your waste cap station. So there are three places it can clog. If you connect to distilled water and clean it overnight, the distilled water is going to clean off white ink from all three. And this needle is the white ink that we removed inside tube from a custom repair printer. So we want to leave the tubes and the cap station completely clean. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at www.bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers!